Community Education and Empowerment Center is a non-governmental organization that's based in Kenya, and it strives to build the capacity of communities to be actors in their own development. We do this through four main programs. The first program is gender and human rights. The next one is community peace building. Our third program is leadership and good governance. And the fourth program is positive masculinities.
We work with communities, but we have a special focus on women and the youth who have been historically marginalized. It is a fact world over that women are underrepresented in leadership positions and in governance, and as a result, the policies and the laws that are implemented become skewed when women voices are not heard.
Mimi naweza tu nikasema, you know, we are the people who usually go to weeds in other people's sambas. You know, those are the people who are very back. Yani, we are always backwards. Kwa sababu ha, sigejua where to start, sigejua pahali watu wanaenda, sigejua where people are promoted and such.
As a result of that underrepresentation and having worked with women from central Kenya and in particular Murang'a County, the women requested that they would want to have a project where their voices can be heard. And having in the 2010 constitution that brought in devolved governance, and the 2013 elections that brought a new system of governance in the country, we thought that it was prudent for women to be involved in the devolved system.
Kajua devolution is division of power from national government to county government. So tukajua how powers inatoka kwa serikali kuu kuja kwa serikali yetu dogo. Sasa tukajua kuna ile mambo tunastahili kama sisi watu wa county dogo tunaweza fanya tuombe kutoka serikali kuu. Tulijua sasa hiyo ndio inisaidia sana juu nitofautisha what devolution is.
Ni twathomire ta hindi no twiriga twari na MCA tukiona he maundu makoragwo na guku macinani matakinyagira MCA matakinyagira mwangi wa iria na MP no ithu twi na guku ni turamakinyira tukahota kumanengereria nigetha nao magatwara mbere na atumia ine nakuo atumia guku matirahota kuona maundu kana kumenya maundu no riu twathie kundini ni turamera uria tuonete no ratu thomithitio ni githomo kiu.
Through the training, I think we have benefited as women, and I've seen women working hard to improve their living standard.
Training hiyo ni ndathomire maundu maingi muno tondu ni ndamenyire niye mwenyewe na ngimenya guikarania na andu wega na kutungatanira nao ni tondu ni ndahotire guthoma githomo ingithomithia andu na njira nguhe kumaruta kuma kuria macinani kumarehe hakuhi na maundu ma thirikari.
This is the reason why we developed a project whose main objective was gender inclusive governance in Kandara Sub County. To enable us achieve our objective, the project entailed three activities. One was a training for the members of the county assembly, another training for women leaders from the six wards within Kandara Sub County, and public ward forums that were held between the MCAs and the women from their respective wards.
I think they were useful in the sense that they got to know exactly what our role is as MCAs, and then they asked whatever questions that they wanted on their understanding of that role, and I believe they now understand us better than they did before, because one of the things is that one of the major problems that we have on the ground is that the people do not quite understand what devolution is all about. So in this little interaction that we have had with them, they've come to understand what our role is, what the role of an MP is, what I'm supposed to do on the ground, what the MP is supposed to do, and basically even the governor, senator, etc., etc. So I think they are good forums because we are creating that understanding, which is very important for us because we'll be able to work.
They were very useful because they provided a platform where the women in the ward were able to engage me as their leader and involve themselves in participatory development in one way or the other. I think that is one of the most important features of the program, that the women were able to appreciate that they play a critical role in decision making and they are part of the governance structure in terms of how they participate. So that was very important, and I think moving forward that is something that we need to look at very keenly as leaders to ensure that, because women are the big chunk of the population that we have, that their inputs is very needful to us as leaders.
Kati ya hizo vikao niliona wanawake hawakuwa wanajua mambo mingi ya our country, lakini sasa wameelewa juu kama sasa walikuwa wanadhani MCA ati sio wao, walimchagua tu aende kwa office, lakini sasa walielewa wanastahili kwenda kwake, now and then wakipata mashinda tunamuendea. Kwa hivyo tulielewa mengi juu ya hii nini, this during this time tulijua ya kwamba MCA ni wetu na tunastahili kuongea na yeye, kumpatia mashinda yetu, na kila kitu tukiona ako na makosa tunamuelezea, na tukajua mengi ya kwamba hata tunaweza mahali tunaweza enda tukiona ametukosea.
It was very helpful because the women, all the members who are there had the power to know the work of MCA, to know how he can help the community. And they asked the question, like, our MCA is a finance, this is the finance controller in the county government. So he was asked how coffee, because coffee, the area it is coffee we grow, how he can follow so that the coffee can help the community. The other area was concerning milk. We pushed, like now the nini, our dairy is almost to be going on, because the community, when we were together, they pushed our leader, who is the MCA, Mr. Joseph Wakifosho, and he have done marvelous.
Leke juke nditwa teithikire na forum icio tondu akoro ni MCA wito bereo tutionaga tukuhiririe no riu thutha wa guthomithio githomo kiu twathomire ni twahotire kunyitana nao na theini wa wodi twameta tukona ni maroka ni aroka na ciuriria twamuriaga tucokeria maundu maria turenda atwikire agatwikira. Rĩu nĩ tuonire nĩ twateithĩkire na gĩthomo kĩu na tũkaga guoya wa kwaria nake.
Actually, it has been of very much help because one, in my position, I was able to know how I should engage the women, and secondly, on the side of the women, they are able now to very much appreciate my role as a ward representative, and that makes it very much easy for them to understand my position, which is very critical for any leader, that the people you are leading understand your position. So that is very critical and is very important because they got to know what are my specific roles as per the constitution. And I also got to know much of what they need to be addressed as a rectorate.
Yeah, the project has helped me in the sense that once they understand what I'm supposed to do, then it is easier for me to work with very little issues. Because once they understand what I'm supposed to do, then it becomes very easy on the ground for me.
Our objective was to ensure that the MCAs were having an interaction with the members of their wards, and in particular the women who have not had a voice. And we also hoped for informed participation and engagement between the MCAs and the women. To enable us to achieve that, the women that were selected from the 6 wards were further mandated to bring together around 100 women from each ward for a public forum. It was the first time that the women were having a one-on-one with their elected members. And it was an opportunity for the women to bring out the issues that were affecting them in the community.
Turiro akwa ni usajeti tondu ndokagira ngatinda ngiona gucera nikuo kwega no kuma twathomithio githomo kiu mundu okagira na wira wake mesiye tutitigaga kwa gutuagira mahuti ni turatigaga ithaka riu tukoragwo turi na bemwe riu gwa gukoragwo kwi kwa kwifundithio na atumia ari angi ni ndeithikite tondu angoro ni tagiti kiu kya nyumba kumi nyonete kuringana kuma kwa MCA na MP ni kwa gukoro tutiretiganira riu ngahota kuingira kuri yo kuingagira office ni ni mutongoria wa nyumba kumi na ni tuonete undu munene muno tugika nao tondu ndironaga ta tungihota kunyitana nao na ta thigari ci nginya OCS na OSPD tukoragwo tukinyitana tondu ni munene wa nyumba kumi uguo githomo kiu na kuingira na MCA na urutani ucio tureheirwo ni urutani utumite ithuĩ twarame na tutindikange
ijenjetie na njĩra nyingĩ tondu ni ijeheretie guoya thĩinĩ wa mwĩcirĩrie-inĩ wakwa ngahota gũtukana na andũ arĩa angĩ ngahota kũrũgamaga mbere ya andũ ngahota kwaria nao ngahota ona kũigua no hote kwĩrũgamia handũ na nduĩke mũtongoria na njĩra nguhĩ ngahotaga kũrũgama na kuga nĩ ngwenda kura cia ũndũ fulani cia o harĩa tũngĩkorwo tũkĩrĩ
ĩ masomo ini menisaidia sana kwangu njuvire naendelea kuerimika naendelea kuerimisa akina mama tuondoe woga sisi akina mama tuondoe ile fikiri ya kusema tikasi yetu tu ni ya nyumbani ni ya kutusa watoto we have a big role in the society and the country. Mama na wambianga kina mama diye uti wa mgongo. Tufanye juhudi na tujikakamue, iyo woga tuondoe. And ile kitu ya inasema inferiority, tuondoe kabisa. Juu kina mama diye amesimamisa kaunti yake, anasimamisa nyumbani, ata kwa kaunti yote. Sasa iyo imenisaidia sana juu unaona naendrea tu kuongezewa viti. Mamlaka yangu ama uongozi wangu naendrea kupada juu.
Kama mimi nimechaguliwa kama Rocho Ward, kiongozi wa akina mama hii ya Women Sacco, na naonelea tukiendelea hivyo hata naweza jitokeza kwa kama nikiwa nataka kuwania kiti ya MCA, hata saa hii naweza mobilize people na wanaweza nichagua.
Mimi ninaona hiyo masomo imenisaidia sana, sina uoga na mimi niko na yani I am empowered to empower the other women without fear. Mimi ilinisaidia, in fact I am very niko steps ninaendelea tu na niko ahead some steps enyewe mimi kwangu ilinisaidia, imesaidia mpaka family kwa sababu sina roho mbaya na sina nilikuwa tu ninaona I had no hope but now I have hope. Naona ikiendelea hivi hata kazi tunapata kwa sababu ninaona watu ambao tulikuwa nao kwa masomo wanapata wanaendelea kupata kazi na ile kazi wanapata inatusaidia kwa sababu inatukusanya na tunaendelea kwa masomo. We are happy about it. I'm also happy about it.
We, the greatest change that I've seen is that they are now starting to ask the right questions. And that is important. When there is a problem or when there is a challenge, they are able to ask the right questions. And they are able to know who to go to get a solution from. To me, that is the most important thing.
Tena nikaelewa sikuwa najua mambo ya basari. Na ma, tunafika mahali unasikia unashindwa kufunza watoto. Lakini sasa nika MCA tulipokutana na yeye akatuelezea mambo ya basari na akatuelezea offices zenye tutaenda na nikaenda na sasa mtoto wangu hiyo third term akalipiwa basari.
Basari haikuwa inaenda sawa yenyewe. Hiyo ni change ingine ambayo nimeona kwa basari ime change. Kuna change ingine nimeona ya maji. Kuna shida sana huko ya maji na ninaona kabisa maji tutakunywa. Kuna change ingine nimeona ya our disabled person. Iyo ninaona kuna pesa wanapewa na hawana shida sasa.
I think one of the prominent changes is that the women were able to appreciate that they also have a critical role in governance. That they were able to appreciate the principle of public participation, that public participation is not the preserve of men only, that public participation is for, it is inclusive, and within the spirit of affirmative action in the Constitution, the women were able to express themselves, and I think that is very important. I think that is one of the most important features of the program, that the women were able to appreciate that they play a critical role in decision making and they are part of the governance structure in terms of how they participate. So that was very important.
Before going to this training, the women, we are not going to meetings. Even if we are held, there was a public meeting there, they couldn't go. And you know you have to go there to address your problems. Now they are going. Elections, because when we started this, there was no election. They were not attending the elections. They were saying that is not our duty. Now they are waiting evil. Huh? They go to elect. They have, women have become very bright and courageous.
Naonea kama wamesaidika juu sasa wamelewa kuna mahali wanaweza pata cheo kama tuseme kama anataka kiti ya chief anaweza pata juu ni ya kila mtu sio vile tulikuwa tunasema kazi zingine ni za wazee sasa tumeonelea hata wamama wanaweza ingia na wapate kazi na wanaweza pamoja ne.
Na kwa community pia, hao akina mama wakierimika, wanajua their rights. Kuna wengine tuko na wao, wako kwa nyumba kumi. Wengine wanachaguliwa kama kuwa secretary wa vikundi zao. Wengine hata wanasimamia, tuseme kama kuna my MCAs nominated. Kwa hivyo kwa community, unaona kina mama, hata kwa vikundi, wanajua kujipanga vile vile. Ukitaka kufanya jambo kama hii tulikuwa tuna chimba mitaro. Akina mama ndio community walikuwa kipao ya mbele, wanakuja na vitu ya kuchimba mitaro. Kwa hivyo unaona hata wakina mama wanaona kazi sio wanaume tu. Kwa community wanafanya kitu. Hivyo nimesema ilitusaidia juu. Tunaona uongozi wa kina mama uko mbele.
Nitonete magicenjia tondu akoro ni wodi tarutuge ito ya kagundo-ini. Nitukoretwo twina security rights matawa maya magikoragwo farafara nitwikiriirwo to nitwikiriirwo guku kafati githunguri na kagundu na mafarafara makagithondekwo makarimwo na darasa igathondekwo
juu tulipomwambia MCA wetu tunataka maji sasa maji iko kwa nyumba tukamwambia akatuelezea ya kwamba atatufungulia nini kituo cha maziwa na tayari ameanza. Na akatuambia tumueleze mashinda yetu yote. And in most places, mahali penye tulimuambia, tunataka atusaidie, tumeona ameanza. Sasa, tukikosa kuingia kwa uongozi, sisi wanawake, we are not going to be considered. Juu, sasa mashinda yetu, wanaume hawezi ya jua. Lakini kama kuna mwanamke yuko hapo, akiona hatu, we are not considered, anajaribu kunini, diyo tuele, tukumbukwe hata sisi. So, wasichana wakiingia kwa masomo kama haya, vikundi kama hizi, wanaingia wanasoma, wataelewa zaidi. Na tena watajua umuhimu wa kuwa viongozi. Juu sasa kama sasa hivi, kwa in our country, tunahitaji wa those young people, so that in future we will have good generation.
Women should participate because one thing, women, they are more transparent. Eh? And the women of today, they are carrying all the responsibility because men refuse to take the responsibility. So they have to participate so that they can be able to take the responsibility, because if the responsibility you are, it is your home and your society, your community, you have to try where you'll be able. So me, I can say it is good so that the area, my home, the area be uplifted. You'll have power and they will have confidence to educate, and the community will be uplifted in all ways.
Kama tungekuwa na leaders wengi wanawake, hata kazi tungekuwa na makazi, hatungekuwa tuna widi kwa masamba ya watu, tungekuwa tumeajiriwa makazi.
I think there is need for more intensive training, given that what I observed, the women were very much welcoming to the program. They were very much interested. Even now, some of them keep on asking, when are you coming back? When is the CEEC coming? I think they are very much, they are really interested in the training. And I think as we move forward, if there is availability of that platform, again, the training platform, I think it is important so that as many women as possible can be trained. And that is how that is when we shall now talk of that every woman across the world has in their capacity increased. We have always thought that the affirmative action is a sympathy towards women. Well, I think we need to delete that notion, to see affirmative action as a process where women, after being empowered, they are now taking over. Yes, we need to see more women coming on board and exercising their empowerment in terms of in seeking leadership positions.
I think I would like to see more of those trainings involving virtually every segment of the population, because they will make my work easier. The more we interact with them, the better for me. I would also like to see the women take a more active role in especially civic education. They have their chamas, they go to church, they go to clan meetings. They can, for example, take some of the issues to those particular meetings where they go and enlighten the people.
When we carried out an evaluation after the end of the project, the women reported to us that they had seen an improvement in delivery of services. the issues that they had raised that needed to be attended to were being attended to. Case in point were infrastructure, the roads, areas where especially women and children could not be able to cross because of poor roads. Some of them were under construction. Issues to do with health had improved within the wards, increased interaction between the MCAs and the women, and more so having women participating in development projects. We are grateful to the Civil Peace Service for ensuring that the women we worked with now have a voice. We are happy to report that the MCAs also say that they have improved in the way that they were delivering their mandate because they are consulting the women in the community. We are grateful that civic participation is now not just on paper as provided for under the Constitution, but it has become a reality for the women in Kandara Sub County because of the way they are interacting and seeing matters of development taking place. Issues of governance have just moved from being a political issue into a development issue and an issue that affects the women within the community, which is a great improvement. And this is just the beginning, and that we are looking forward to seeing more and more women participate, which is their rightful role in governance processes in Kenya.